When you're ready, Jacob. Yes. Okay. First of all, let me apologize that I'm not funny as Hagai or Chaya. However, I will bring some common sense back to this debate. Okay. One main point I'm going to make you today, which will be directly clashing with Chaya, is this will strengthen the Hamas regime. The EU does not want to help Hamas, it wants to help Gazans, and this will do exactly the opposite. We'll explain why for two main reasons. A, democracy, B, peace. Before that, quick rebuttal. First of all, regarding war, Chaya comes to us, come on. You're seriously suggesting that the EU will go into war with the whole world and everything. We're far-fetched when Israel wants to protect itself. So who's far-fetched? B, Alon did not say that Israel will attack the EU. Not something very simple. Israel will threaten that any ship that enters its territorial line will be shot. Hey, we've seen this happen before. Where the Cuban missile crisis. You don't actually have to start a war. Only to just threaten to start a war for the other side to retreat. If the EU retreats, you didn't achieve anything besides losing your global influence, which is so important for you suddenly. So that's B. Three, and by the way, that's the 99% that Israel will retaliate, not that a war will definitely begin, which I'll be very clear. See, we say that there is still a chance that war will begin. And why is that? Because if the EU does not retreat, we'll have a standoff, we'll have a chicken game. Each side will stay close to the territorial wire, and we'll see who flinches first, who makes the first mistake. And in these situations, sometimes someone does something by accident, sometimes someone does the wrong calculations, and war will begin. One example, World War I. No one wanted that war, and hey, tens of millions of people killed. So that's for the, oh, it's ridiculous. Secondly, I will give you four reasons why Israel will retaliate. A, public opinion. B, coalition. C, deterrence. D, flow of weapons. What was the reply that you received? Are you serious? So we want a much better reply from the second proposition to why Israel will not retaliate. Then are you serious? Thirdly, the only thing that we did here is, no, Israel cares about the economic ties into the EU. So let's see what it cares more about. The very likely possibility that Hamas will now have the ability to fire direct missiles and just put down Azrieli or put down the Hadar power station and shut Israel down versus the economic ties of the EU. I think even economically speaking, ignoring all the people dying, this is a much worse option, Hamas having long-range missiles that can just shut Israel down, no faith. Then we heard, okay, but we're trying to liberate, I don't have time, okay, to liberate the people in Gaza from the Hamas. Now what was the logic we got here? We got two things. First of all, growing economy equals liberal democracy. We do not accept that logic. It was not explained. It's not always true. We have Singapore, we have all the Arab Qatar, etc. And we have many things. B, we heard, for now Hamas controls the supply, then they won't. Why won't they? They still will decide who sends humanitarian aid. They still will control the trade. They still will determine who gets what. What we're saying is, why does Hamas control everything there? Because it's an evil dictatorship. It's as simple as that. Finally, we heard other countries will be settled. So we said that three things. First of all, they assume that this will be successful. Because to get a deterrence, you have to succeed. If, on the other hand, there will be a standoff and the EU retreats, so other countries will think exactly the opposite. B, we say, you seriously think that after this, Iran and Syria would say, oh, we just give up a regime, oh, I don't want to be, I'm willing to give up because the EU threatened Israel. No, we do not think so. We think Iran and Syria have much more to lose. C, we say, if anything, we will see the opposite. Why that? Because Russia and China, the superpowers that you want to influence, which aren't exactly democracies, you want to liberate, have much respect to sovereignty rights, and this will be much more important to them, and they will actually disconnect from the EU and not the other way around. Got that? Okay. Let's begin. No, thank you. Let's begin with my point. What we're saying is that the EU wants to help the Palestinians. That's what the EU is about, and with that we agree with first part. We want to help human rights, morally, etc. Now, let's remember why is there, Israel is currently having a siege on Gaza, and this siege is actually supported by much of the Western world. And why is it supported by much of the Western world? For two reasons. First of all, because Hamas is an evil dictatorship, and I will explain this. Secondly, because they do not accept the peace process. Let's go one by one. What does this mean, an evil dictatorship? First of all, it means a violent revolution. B, it means the oppression of women. C, it means the oppression of gays. You see the pattern here? What do they want to liberate? Muslim women, gays, all of these people are people oppressed by the regime they're helping. indeed even oppression and violence against political enemies. So no democracy whatsoever. What are you doing here? You're, first of all, you're legitimizing this regime. Secondly, you're giving power to the oppressor instead of the oppressee. What does this mean? Hamas will now have only more strength. It will have the economic ties. It will decide who gets what. And what do you think? Do you think that Hamas will give all these new things to the gays and the women? No, they will give these things to the Hamas supporters and not to Fatah people. That's the first reason. Second reason, after I take, you know.
Don't you agree that the most important thing is to EU is what's good for the EU?
Yes, and we think what's good for the EU, according to first prop, is to help the Gazans because they're so poor and the morality, etc., etc. Okay, we accept first proposition that the EU should care about Gaza. Okay, second about the Gazan people. Second explanation regarding the peace process. So what we're saying here, notice, Hamas has no territorial disagreements with Israel, yet they have not even agreed to think about recognizing Israel or about talking to them in any negotiation. They're not only disagreeing with Israel on a specific agenda, they won't even negotiate. They completely object the entire notion of a peace process. Not only that, they even claim that no peace is possible until Israel completely leaves the entire area, which we all know is not a possibility. Why is this important? Because currently we have two Palestinian regimes, one of them which supports peace, one of them which supports building its own country, West Bank, if anyone missed it, and the second one which chose war and continues choosing war day by day. Not only did it choose war, it chose a dictatorship. Now, which one is the EU supporting? And let's just be clear, you can't implement this thing in the West Bank because then you can't just bring many ships. The Israel army is actually in the West Bank, so that is not a possibility. So which one are you actually helping? You are helping the one that chose the violence. Why is this important? First of all, the status and legitimation, etc. But secondly, you're also telling the Palestinian people who support from now on. Do not support people who try to help you, who make the situation better, who support peace. Support, you're telling them, support the side who wants war. And why is this bad? I think this is obvious, but let's just be clear. Because we think that as long as we have more regimes like Hamas, if we have a Hamas regime in the West Bank as well, we have less chance of peace and a bigger chance of war. We know who will win this war. Israel, like, usually does, and we know this means a lot of Gaza fatalities. We know this means a much worse situation for Gaza, like we had Gaza. For all of those reasons, this will make the situation in Gaza and in the West Bank much worse for all of the Palestinians. Therefore, we call you to oppose.